Praise the Lord. All right, Grandpa Ipo, and Pastor Lutz has been, I've known him since I was a little child, and his passion is really for the lost. His passion is really to reach out to people, and he and a lot of other pastors in Ipoh have, you know, reached out to the Indian community, and they have been a tremendous blessing to them, right? And I was back there a couple of weeks ago for a funeral, and it was for an Indian family, and I could see how all the Indian churches came together and really rallied together, and I could see the fruits of his labor. And so today he is with us, and the funny thing is, I was looking for speakers to preach on Father's Day, but I because of the last minuteness, I couldn't find anyone. But he came up to me, "Joel, I'm coming down on Father's Day. I'm going to preach at Victory Church." I said, "Yes, you're going to preach at Victory Church." And so he's really here to bless us. Let's put our hands and put our hearts together. Welcome, Pastor Luke. Praise the Lord. Wow, you're very silent. Huh? Hallelujah. Come on, Victory Church. Praise the Lord. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and say, "The Father in heaven loves you this morning." Praise the Lord. You know, we were here, in fact, Thursday. All right, we came for FGB Asian Conference, because I was helping up in the marketplace ministry with FGB ministry in our where the place that I work, and as pastor, they have invited, all right, to attend this conference all free of charge. Amen. It's good to be the servant of God. Amen. When the blessing of God comes, it comes very fine and good. All right, we've been host in the Majestic Hotel, the seminar, and we put in the Vistana Hotel, and me and my wife was invited, and all free, hallelujah! Amen! How many of you believe that God bless you at the correct time and the correct place? Amen! Hallelujah! So we had an awesome time, alright? And we hear great testimony of how FGB ministry is going on, and we have about 30 nations attended the conference. And this marketplace ministry is very effective, and it's very powerful, because if you want to call somebody to the church, they feel very frightened. They thought you want to convert them. They say, "I'm fine with my religion. I don't want to become a Christian." But in the marketplace ministry, it's a non-threatening ministry. All right, and you just buy a ticket and sponsor. You say, "Just come for a businessman fellowship, and I will buy you a lunch," and they'll come. We are not knowing that we have set a trap for them. Alright? And when they hear the worship, and when they hear the powerful testimony of the speakers and the brothers, or some people, God done great miracle in their life, and they hear the testimony, and they know that Jesus can save, Jesus can heal, and Jesus can give life. Hallelujah! Alright, and we have seen many souls that come in terms of this kind of ministry and to evangelize. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So God has been very good, and I saw Pastor Joel coming to Ipoh to preach, and I said, "Since I'm coming to KL, okay," I told him, "I'm coming to KL," and then he said, "Yeah." He said, "When are you coming to preach?" Alright, and God answered prayer. In fact, he's longing for somebody to come and preach. Amen. So I'm the one God said, "Here, my son, you." Alright, so that's why I'm here in Victory Church, and I want to thank God for God's blessing upon my life, my ministry. I want to thank my wife, Lena. Can you stand up, please? Alright, be married to her for 30 years. Alright, she's the 101 wife that I fall in love with. God bless you. Alright, today my sons are here, alright, Jonathan and Brendan. Alright, will you stand up, boys? And Jessica and Tracy, all right, we are heavily guided. Praise the Lord. Thank you, all right, and thank Pastor Lemuel and Pastor Joel, and their wife, their children. I see Victory Church really marching on to victory. All right, I see that big bus over there. All right, and a lot of people need to go into that bus. Hallelujah. And Harvard is driving the bus. Hallelujah. All right, he's going to be the young pastor. Amen. Hallelujah. Because you're sitting in the driver's seat, watch out, my brother. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. How many of you love your Heavenly Father? Amen. Today is a great joy to celebrate Father's Day with you. And Father's Day is always wonderful to share, because fathers go through a lot of struggle in life. All right, so father is a greater calling than our ministry. All right, a father need to be with his family. A father need to, you know, to nurture the sons and daughters. And as a father, we have a great responsibility to live a life that we will show the father's love through our life. You know, somebody sent a message to me at that postcard saying, all right, he that loved God, and he that loved God and understand the love of God, he will learn to love his wife and children just like the Heavenly Father. All right? So the Bible says, all right, the love of God is shared about by the Holy Ghost. Amen. All right? The Holy Ghost is the one that gives us the powerful love to stir our spirit, all right, to draw to the love of the Father, to love Him so we can love the one who is beside us. All right? So awesome to see that the video. All right? I can see all the young fathers, the young children. I'm telling you, your church is going to be a powerful youth church. Amen. I can see Pastor Lemuel, doctor, playing electric guitar. Wow. Powerful, man. All right. That's powerful. Hallelujah. All right. So God is good, and I want to thank God. Can we have a word of prayer before we hear the word of God? Father God in heaven, we come to you in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, as we celebrate Father's Day, Father, you are the Father of all, Father. Lord, your love will be demonstrated through the preaching of your word. I pray that every father, Lord, as they hear the word, the Father's love will be, Lord, be, Lord, revealed, O God, so powerfully into their life. They will continue, O God, be bonded, O Father, with your love. And Lord, your love cover multitudes of sin. Lord, your love will bring them victory. Your love will give them strength. Your love will continue, O God, to lead them, O God, to the kingdom of God. Father, commit this time to your precious hand. Lord, I pray, Lord, give me wisdom and knowledge and revelation as I preach the word of God. The people of God be blessed and receive today and walk out, Lord, with joy of the Father. In Jesus' name I ask and pray. And the people of God say,
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So, happy Father's Day to everyone over here. All right. And those who are going to be father, all right, you're in the right place at the right time. Amen. I think this is the best training place in Victory Church. Okay, because we have a lot of young fathers over here. Alright, I don't see much gray hair as a Pastor Diane. Hallelujah. He's already grandfather. He promoted to a higher level. Alright. Alright. So good to see Chris and his husband Simon. Oh, God bless you. Ho Chi Minh City. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you. Alright. Okay. Somebody can turn on my sermon. My sermon title, The Father's Love. Alright, The Father's Love. The Father's love is so important. As a child of God, we can't live without the Father's love. Alright, there's a powerful scripture tell us how the Father's love be manifested in our life. Next. Romans 8:15, it says, since I'm so tall, I better go this way. Alright, Romans 8:15, it says, the spirit that you receive does not make you slave. Alright? The spirit, the Bible says the spirit. What spirit that you receive? You receive the Holy Spirit. When you receive the Holy Spirit, you're no longer slave, the Bible says. But, the Bible says, so that you will live in fear again, rather the spirit that you receive brought about your adoption to sonship. Amen. You are sonship. The spirit that God gave to us to adopt us as his sonship. And without that spirit, and the Bible says, by him we cry out what? Abba Father. So today we have the Holy Spirit of God, and you already received the Holy Spirit. You are received the authority of a sonship. So you live a life like a son. You live a life and you walk your life with a power and authority. Because Jesus says, all right, unless you're born again in John 5:5, John 3:3, all right, you cannot enter the kingdom of God. And today, I believe all of us have entered the kingdom of God. So when you come to enter the kingdom of God, and you have been given the title as sonship. That's why as a son, God has given you power and authority to continue to live in that kingdom. The kingdom of God, when you are in the kingdom of God, everything is possible. Amen. You see, when God created Adam and Eve, he so much desired that he wanted to have the father and the son relationship. And somehow, Adam and Eve choose the tree of knowledge, good and evil, they fall. So the Father in heaven, he longed to have the relationship with. So when Jesus came in the New Testament, he revealed the Father loves to us so powerfully. Jesus said, if you see me, you see my Father. You see, whatever I do, whatever the Father does, I do. Whatever the Father say, I say. So do you have the intimacy with your Father this morning? Without the Father, the Father presence in your life, you were not able to do the things that you want to do. Because the Holy Spirit gives us power to be the sons of God, daughters of God. But the love of the Father is so powerful to keep us intact in the presence of God. That's why there's a survey they conducted in Singapore that out of 100 families, alright, out of 100 family, 80 family who don't have a father, the sons will go into drug addict, they will come gangster, alright, they come robbers, alright, they come all kind of into all these wrong societies, alright, without a shadow of the father. 80% of services in Singapore, the family who don't have a father figure, the sons will always rebel. And the daughters, alright, is if they don't have father, what happened? They go and find sugar daddy. So there's a great danger, and today we as a church, we have the obligation and we have the responsibility to preach the Father's love. Without the Father's love, we have been lost. That's why Jesus came to reveal the Father to us. That's why Jesus says, alright, I have come that you may know the Father. Each time when Jesus speaks, alright, as my Father says, so I say. So there was a great, a strong bonding with Jesus and the Heavenly Father. So as the sons and daughters of God this morning, you need to draw to your Heavenly Father. Like each morning when you get up, first thing you pray is say, Father, I thank you for your love. Always affirm the love of your Father into your life. So when you have the love of the Father, you feel secure. Because the Word of God says, alright, because the Word of God says, alright, when you not to make you slave, so that you will live in fear. Those who don't have the Father, they don't have the Holy Spirit in them, we always live in fear. We live uncertainties. We live that's not a pillar to support us. But when you receive Jesus Christ as a Lord and Savior, when you begin to receive the Holy Spirit, and the Father, the Heavenly Father, comes out. That's what Jesus says to the disciple, whenever you pray, pray, Our Father who art in heaven. Jesus prayed each time, alright, to the Father. Each time when he spoke to the disciple was confused. They said, Show me the Father. Jesus said, if you see me, you have seen the Father. They were confused. And many people are today in the church, they are also confused. They don't understand the love of the Father. Without the love of the Father, you cannot, all right, grow in your spiritual walk. You cannot grow in your relationship with the living God. So the love of the Father is so important. So let us move on. So this is a famous story that Jesus told, the parable. He told about three parables. Parable number one was the lost coin and the lost animal. And Jesus zeroed into this lost son. Many of you say, hey, I know this story. Yeah, yeah, you know this story. But you ever felt the love of the Father when you begin to reach this passage? That's the most important. Many people say, oh, the son came back. All right, but it's not about the son. Even though there was one younger son, there was elder son. All right, both of them are lost. But the father, the story is about the father's love. Amen? So let us just go on. Jesus continued, and there was a man who had two sons. The younger son said to the father, Father, give me my share of my estate. In Chinese, all right, before the fathers die, when a children come and ask for their estate, you know, normally people, you know, in Chinese custom, sure the mother will stand up and say, they love you like Papa said, yo man! Yeah, Papa may say, yeah, I want to change on me, yeah! Not typical, you know, typical. All right, I have to be very Chinese because I have a Chinese wife. All right. You know, it's just like a curse. When you ask for your father's inheritance before even he died, it is a curse. But the younger man in this world, the father gave my share of the estate. So he divided his property between them. You know, the father was so gracious. You know, he did not say, you know, son, don't make a silly mistake. When I give it to you, you might, you know, end up in misery or end up in trouble. The father was willing. This story came out of the mouth of Jesus. He said, the father divided the property. Verse 13. Not long after that, the young man got together and all he had, he set out for the distant country and squandered his wealth in wild living. And after he had spent everything, there was a severe famine in that whole country, and he began to be in need. Next one. So he went and hired himself out there to be a citizen of that country, who sent him to the field to feed the what? Pig! Char siu! Siu yok! All right, my second son, Sia, you know, Sia, he cannot control himself. He wagged the Sia. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Verse 16, so he longed to fill his stomach with the pots that the pigs were eating, but no one gave him anything. I think this boy was not a Chinese. Because if he's a Chinese, definitely he already roasted the pig and he had the pig, not the pork. Right? Somebody told me, all right, if Adam and Eve were a Chinese couple, I say serpent would have died long ago because they would make nice soup of it. I think Adam and Eve must be, they had a Hindu culture. Look at this thing and say, wow. You know, they see everything also different. If they're Chinese, they say, no problem, the job is finished, hallelujah. But here, I think this guy is not a Chinese. I think he must be a Jewish boy. Alright, otherwise, if it is my son, he would have barbecued the pig and have nice char siu. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So verse 17, when he came to his senses, he said, how many of my father's hired servants have food to spare? And here I am starving to death. Verse 18, I was sent out and go back to my father's house and say to him, Father, I sinned against heaven against you. I no longer want you to be called your son. Make me like one of your servants. Wow, this young guy not say stupid, but also very intelligent. Alright, now he come, he spent all his money, everything. Now he understand while he was in the father's house, he had plenty to eat. He had plenty to dine. In everything that he wanted in his father's house. Alright, he miscalculated leaving the father's house is the biggest trouble. Alright, when my children came to KL, alright, my daughter came, and then my Jonathan came, and then Brandon came. So he stand alone, he said, Mommy, when I come this week, please cook me the chicken curry. Mommy, please cook me the paru-paru curry. You know, they miss the father's house food. It's difficult to leave the father's house. Because in the father's house, I believe there was great love for the boys, but they did not realize. Like many of us, we thought we can venture out and become somebody. It's good to come as somebody, but only remember the Father's love. Do not depart from the Father's love. That's what the Bible says, all right? Honor your father and mother, that you will be blessed and you will live long. Amen. You want to live long? You don't need to eat healthy, you don't need to exercise, and you know, keep all the iron every day. Just honor your father, mother, and you will live. Alright? Don't waste your money and all the vitamin and all the gym. I don't care, very expensive. Alright? Because that's why the Bible says, alright, the word of life gives you life. Amen. So love your honor your father and mother, then you will live long. Amen. So let us go back. Alright, verse 20. But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion. Our Heavenly Father had compassion. That's what Jesus said when he saw the multitude, alright, he had compassion for them. Because they saw they were like a sheep without a shepherd. No one to tend them. No one to feed them. So Jesus saw he was moved with compassion. If God called you to the ministry, one of the important, alright, you must have compassion for the lost souls. Because the soul of a man is priceless. That's why in Proverbs 11:30 it says, he that win a soul is wise. Amen. You know, I mean, God will, you know, when we meet Jesus face to face, I believe when God calls us to enter into his presence, only he would ask us not so much, you know, what car you drive, you know, what condo that you stayed, you know, what you achieved this, what you achieved that. You know, God wants to bless us so many things in this world because as our soul prosper, we prosper. But when we see our Savior, he will ask you one question, how many souls that you brought to me? How many souls? A man who with a soul is wise. So brothers and sisters, take the opportunity. Alright, I know Victory Church is going to the direct direction. I believe, alright, not my mind, not my power, as you go to the theater, I believe God is going to give you an explosion of his power, the power in his presence, and people are going to come to hear the gospel in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Go by faith. We don't know where we go. Like Abraham, God called. He walked by faith. A lot of people say, why don't we stay here? It's so nice and cozy. When I came here, why? Like, I thought, wow, I entered the church. I entered some lounge. It was so dark. And it was, the music was so nice, you know. And then on the church, on the light, oh, there's a church here. Praise the Lord. So the Father had compassion. Pastors, leaders, you are here. Do you have the compassion? If you don't have compassion, pray. You know, if you have not a burden, the Bible says you pray, and God will give you the burden to reach out. Better for him to say no and the one Jesus, rather he did not hear the gospel one time. That's why I told my wife. I said, never mind. Just bring your friend. We have a lot of business meeting, alright? Just bring the friend, because each time we have a banquet dinner, alright, always I have one table, two tables, be thrown to me. God is so good, you know, when blessing comes, he throws it. So what do you do? Take the opportunity in why? Okay, our friends, our family, our loved family. You see, tonight we're having a dinner in this restaurant. I say the food is good. Don't talk about Jesus yet. The food is good. I say, you come. That's how we evangelize. There's so many ways to evangelize the real soul for the Lord Jesus Christ. So we must have the compassion. Without compassion, you're not able to do anything for the Lord. Because Jesus said, when you look at the multitude, he was moved with compassion. Sometimes you just feel after 8 days, 8 hours of work, 9 hours of work, you come back, suddenly you hear, Pastor, can you come and pray for me? I'm admitted in the hospital. After a tired day, you don't feel like, you know, getting out from your sofa, set and, you know, take a shower and go to the hospital, pray. Then when you go and pray for the person, when God performed the miracle, and when he testified, many people are be blessed, and many come to know Jesus Christ, the Lord and Savior. There's a price to pay. Amen? There's a price to pay. Because if a man does not have compassion for the lost, alright, he has lost the love of the Father in his life. When you have the love of the Father in your life, you will go. You know, I was preaching in Patilaja Church, and my wife, a business associate, called because he was suffering 7 days, very high fever. He tested his blood, nothing wrong. 7 days, every night, 10 o'clock, the fever come, until morning, 3 o'clock, on and on and on and on, 7 days. So he know that, you know, that I'm a pastor, and my wife said, just received a call from my friend, all right, can we go pray? He said, it's feeling getting worse. So after preaching from Patilaja, which is about 25 miles away from Ipoh, all right, and he stay in Sunway, all right, another 25 minutes, all right, after preaching so tired, but I just felt compassion for this man who suffered so long. So I went to the house. He's a very wealthy man. Alright, he's a very wealthy man. So I went there. On the way, I asked the Holy Spirit to give me wisdom and show me what's wrong with this man. Lord, show me what's wrong with that. Because the Bible says in Romans 8:15, God has given us a spirit of sonship so we can communicate to God and ask, Lord, anything that we want to see in the spiritual realm. So I asked the Lord, as I went to his house, so I saw him, I lay my hand and pray, and I command in the name of Jesus, every fever, leave right now. Don't you enter this body evermore. I break the power of the fever and command a restoration and healing. And suddenly I got a vision. Alright, suddenly I got a vision, and the Holy Spirit says, alright, 2 weeks ago, a visitor came to your house. You know, sometimes the Holy Spirit give you, it won't give you exactly point, all right? He just stood up, all right? He said, a visitor came, he shall post not to come. So I asked the husband, all right, last week anybody came? He said, Pastor, a lot of people come to my house. I don't know who you are telling. I said, this visitor supposed to not come. Oh. He said, yeah, Pastor, just 1 week ago, the black color serpent was right in front of my house. Alright? So he saw the serpent and he took the picture and he kept it on the phone. Alright? When I asked him, did you see the serpent? He said, on his phone, he said, Pastor, what? There was a big black cobra. Alright? So I bind the spirit of serpent that tried. Because John 10:10, Jesus says very clearly, the enemy comes to steal, to kill, and what? to destroy. Jesus said, I've come that you may have life and more what? Abundant life. So bind the spirit of serpent and cleanse his house with the word of God. And I lay hand and anoint him. And after that, 11 o'clock, my wife, the same day, received a message. The wife texted, said, Lina, thank you so much. All right, for you and your husband to come and pray. It's already 11 o'clock. The fever never come back this morning. And then next morning, he said, my husband already gone back to work. When you have compassion, miracle happens. Because you have the spirit of sonship. Amen. That's what Jesus said in John 7:38-39. All right, out of your heart shall flow rivers of water. When the river of water flow upon your life, whoever touch the river give life. The river give restoration. The river give healing. You see, the tree I planted in between the river is always the tree, always strong and healthy, and the leaves are always green. And the leaves are used for healing. So flow the river. Wherever the river flows, it gives life. Amen. Because you're a son, sheep. You're a son of God. That's how many times I go to church and pray, I say, you don't know who you are in Christ Jesus. That's the problem. You always complain, back pain, that pain, this trouble, that trouble. Because as a son, you don't know who you are. If you know the son, if you know you're the son of God, you take your authority and command all this infirmity to leave. Because Jesus says, okay, whatever you bind in earth will be bound in heaven. Hallelujah. Whatever you loose in the earth will be loose in heaven. So take your authority. Your church is victory. Every time you meet the people, there must be victory. Because you're walking in the spirit of victory. I'm glad the church is called victory. Because each time I pray, Father, I pray as I go and pray, Lord, give me victory. So today I'm in the very church that gave me victory. Amen. So I will be victorious when I leave this place. When you leave this place, you'll be victorious. Let's come back and see. Are you with me? Alright, I think I just finished yet. Okay. He ran to his son and threw his arm around him and kissed him. Alright, he said, the father saw him. The father, he said, while he was still long way off. A rebellious son don't need that kind of welcome. Alright? If we are earthly children, they rebel against us, straight away we say, okay, 1 week, cannot use internet. Alright? Cannot use debit card. Number two, no TV. Number four, only vegetarian food for you. Number five, no pocket money, because what you've done is wrong. But this father did not count or look at his sin. Because the love of the Father is so strong. That's why the Bible says, the love covers multitude of sin. God is no more judging us for our sin. But he's looking, all right, that you will have a powerful relationship with your Father. All right, let's go back to the Word of God. Amen. So he read. He said the son ran back, the father ran. The Bible says, wow, he's a wonderful father, isn't he? He ran. And then what happened? Alright, so he ran to his son and threw his arm around him. And he what? Kissed him. Certain words he said, he kissed again and again and again. And look, remember this son came back from the pig farm. Oh, what Chinese say? Oh, smelly! Each time when I go for funeral, when I go to the mortuary, my wife say, hey, before I enter, go wash your leg outside. Alright? And then he say, take out all the clothing, go to the downstairs bathroom, take a shower there first. Then I can enter the master room with the queen. I said, I did not go to the pig farm.
I did not go to the cow farm. I just went to do my ministry. He said, no. No choice that. Love and obey her. Right.
So the father ran and put her arms around him and kissed him. Mum. It was not one kiss. You know, now my children are all grown up. All right, when they're small, you know, easy to kindle them, hug them, but they don't remember. All right, but now when they are adult, I kiss them more than I kissed when they were younger age. Each time they come back, and they say, "Daddy," I go to hug and give them a kiss and give them the father's assurance that I love them. So each time my elder son come, I'll kiss my elder son and hug him. And my daughter come, I'll kiss her and hug. And my little boy, the last one, the Brandon, all right, the most naughty one, he come back, all right, I'll kiss him because the sentiment will come, the hand, he say, "Father or Daddy." Yeah. So you have a daddy God. We call him Daddy God. You know, mother's kiss all spoiling the children, you know. Yeah. Father kiss is, you know, affirmation. Today my son say, "You buy me lunch, so it's okay, my wife doesn't buy me lunch." You know, brothers, sisters, fathers, kiss your children as much as possible when they are teenagers. Because they need the love. Why you say, they're grown up, you know, you don't want this all the touchy-touchy thing. When you have the love of the Father, it shall flow like a river. When the river flow, it touch life and give life. Hallelujah. So when Yvonne married a husband, he is not so used to hugging and all that. But now they hug more times than my wife each time I see him. Yesterday we had Father's Day, get together with the family. He came and hugged me. He hugged me really hard. Because why? I demonstrate the Father's love to him. Even he's my son-in-law, I hug him and I kiss him. I say, "Nice to see you, baby. Nice to see you." So each time when I lay a kiss upon my son, they only remember the Father's affirmation that I have nothing against them. My love for them is always pure and clean. I don't look at their mistake, their fault, but with the love of God, able to restore them when they go wrong. Able to sit down there and talk to them. Alright? Many parents tend to, you know, scream and yell. That's the wrong way to bring up the children. Look at the father. When he saw, he ran. And he just kissed. So sometimes your children come back late, he say, "You came back 2 o'clock, I don't know, I've been waiting late." Today you don't lunch for you. Why not you give the lunch and tell them, "You know, Daddy loves you. Try not to come late because the day is up. Speak wisdom." Amen? God has given us wisdom. If you say no wisdom, Book of James say, "Ask for wisdom and God will give you wisdom." So, brothers and sisters, we must able to bring our children in the love of the Father. Or else the father kissed him over and over, and verse 21, the son said to him, "Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I'm no longer worthy to be called your son." That's why I go to many churches and I pray, or that many Christians that say, "God doesn't answer my prayer because I've done something wrong." You see, Christ died and he was bruised and was, you know, smacked again and again for your sin. You're a little bit wrong, God going to turn his back against you? I say, no, it's a lie of the devil. But the Bible says, 1 John 1:9, if you have sinned, confess your sin, and God ready to forgive you just like that. You see, God always have something for you to come back. Something for you to come back to him. But I say, no. He says, certain thing happening in my life because God is judging me. Because I didn't do this, I didn't do that. I think God is judging me. I'm going to a terrible time. I say, God is not judging. God already judged Jesus once for all at the cross for you and for me. Today we need to live a life with the love of the Father. So many people
After I'll come.
All right.
Let me talk about the second son first. All right. Amen.
So verse 24. All right. For this son of mine. Let us have a feast and celebrate. All right, today Father's Day, so let us celebrate. So let us have a feast and celebrate. For this son of mine was dead and alive again. He was lost and he was found. So you begin to celebrate. You see, a loss of a soul is so precious to our Heavenly Father. Because we have to make a decision before we leave this world. Either we want to choose this passage, or we want to choose this passage. When God created Adam and Eve, alright, He planted two trees. One is the tree of life. One is tree of knowledge, good and evil. And what happened? And then it chose the second tree. So they gain knowledge. They know what is good and bad. But they disobey God. But many people say, why God did not go in the wind and stop? You know, hey, don't go to the tree. Stop, don't go to the tree. You know, God, if He comes to you and He give you a gift to Pastor Joel, and He not going to take back that gift, because a gift is given free. So God gave Adam and Eve a choice. They had all the power and authority to rule what God had given them. But when He gave them the power and authority, they began to exchange with them. So what happens, Satan? That's why this world is fallen. This world is cursed. But thank God we are the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Long as you're the kingdom of God, supernatural power of God always delivers us. Hallelujah. When you're the kingdom of God, you always overcome. Because Jesus said, I have overcome the world, so you will overcome. So those who are the kingdom of God are overcomers. I'm going to be one. I'm going to finish. Hallelujah. So meanwhile, the older son, all right, the older son was in the field. When he came near the house, he heard music and what? Dancing. He was far away. The elder son heard the music and dancing which he never heard before. You see, in my father's house, in our father's house, I said there must be music and dancing. When you come to church, there might be music and dancing. Hallelujah. And Victory Church have so gifted musicians, when I enter, I feel like dancing. Many I enter there, I feel like dancing. Because the music is so good. But if you come back to Mother Church, like you guys play so lively, so powerfully, all right, now Mother Church, many you say, hey, turn down the music, my ears are very painful. And many old people cannot take loud music. Alright? They find a church with a choir to them. Alright? They sing all the hymns. Alright? What a friend we have in Jesus. Maybe some will lose, but God is going to bring one you go, 10 going to come back. Hallelujah. Amen? So he heard dancing and music in the Father's house. So he called one of the servants and asked him what was going on. The brother had come and he said, your brother has come. And he replied, your father had killed a fattened calf because he has him back safe and sound. You know, fattened calf is most expensive calf. You can cut an adult calf, but a fattened calf is very expensive. Calf, very young. Alright, expensive. So, move on. Right. So the older son became what? Angry. Refused to go in. So the father went out and pleaded with him. Verse 29 says, but he answered his father, look, all these years I have been serving you and never disobeyed your orders, yet never give me a young goat so I could celebrate with my friend. Alright, he said, all these years I've been serving you and never disobeyed. Alright, he was living on the law. He was not living on God's grace. Alright, he followed all the law of the Father. Alright, he did not know. Alright, and verse 30. So when his son of
Yours, who have squandered your property with prostitution and came home, you killed the fattest calf for him. So you see, one son genuinely took the money and was lost, but came back. But one son is in the father's house, but he doesn't know the blessing of the father. Many doesn't know the blessing of your father. The favor of God will cause you to reign, because you're safe now. Now you're safe, and through the righteousness of Christ, you will reign in His life. And all the blessing that God had for you come from the Father. He was in the Father's house, but he doesn't know the Father's blessing. If the Father collapsed and died with a heart attack, 100%, the elder son will inherit his property. He did not know. So many of us in the church doesn't know the blessing of the Father. That's why you always come back and say, oh, having this problem, having that problem. Alright, because you never talk to your Heavenly Father. All you need to say, Father, alright, I know you love me so much. And Father, bless me, prosper me. Whatever I do, I shall prosper. Because the Bible says, God's favor will cause you to reign in this life. If there's an interview, you will be the first candidate that God will, you know, that the interviewer will pick you up, because you're a child of God, you're the favor of God. But do you go like them and go interview and say, Father, I want the job, alright? Not just the job, Lord, I want the job, and I want to be the supervisor of the company. I claim it by faith. Because you don't know your authority, you don't claim, so it doesn't belong to you. So same, the elder son. Okay, one more. So my son, the father said, you are always with me. Everything I have is what? Yes. You're always here. Everything you have is what? Yes. Everything that's written in the Word of God, it is yours. I shall not be defeated. I shall not be sick. I will not see troubled days, but I will see good days. I will see good breaks. My business shall prosper. My children will prosper. Because the Bible says no more troubled days, but good days. Because 1 John 4:17, he says, as Jesus was in this world, so we are. One lady, you know, went for an cancer X-ray. So he went and he found there's a lump in the cancer. And she heard the gospel that, you know, as Jesus was, we are in this world. So she went and the doctor confirmed there's a lump. And the second time she went for another test, another doctor confirmed. So third time she went to the doctor and she wrote a letter to the doctor. He said, as Jesus is, so I am this world, because Jesus did not have breast cancer. Why I have breast cancer? After 1 week, the breast cancer disappeared in Jesus' name. Yeah. So do you know who you are? You are the little Jesus, hallelujah! You command, demons have to flee. You command, sick have to go. You can raise the dead. Jesus said, I give you all power and authority. Go and preach the kingdom of God. Heal the sick, raise the dead. Do everything, because my Father will give it to you. You cannot be a victorious church, a victory church, but don't understand the promise of God. When people walk to your church, they must have victory. Because you know how to dispense God's victory into the life of the people. So when I preach in the temple churches, I tell you, they love me. I put a lot of it. Okay, every time mutton curry, chicken curry, say, Pastor, come, eat, please. Make sure next week come again. Because they're so hungry for the Word. When they see signs and what the miracle, they won't let you go. You know, Jesus says, these signs will follow. Amen? Just one more minute, right? But when he had celebrate and be glad, because of this, the brother of yours was dead and is alive again. He was lost, now is found. So many people like the first son, did wrong, came back, and got the father restored. But many people are in the church, but they're lost. Their body is here, but the heart is not here, and they don't understand the word of God. So because of that, Satan come and defile. Satan come and rob you. Because you have the because the Bible says, all right, the lack of the knowledge. My people perish because of the lack of the knowledge of the word of God. So read your Bible. Go to your life group. Get yourself grounded in the word of God. So the Father loves. He loves you so much. So we stand together. I just want the fathers to come to the altar. I just want to pray for you. I know I am a father of three children. Alright, it's not easy to manage. Sometimes I don't have wisdom. Sometimes I don't know what to say. But the power of the Holy Spirit of God, and by the anointing of the Spirit of the Lord, and able to overcome as a father. So I invite your fathers, all fathers, please come, all right? There's nothing to be shy of. I just want to pray for you and ask God blessing, all right, that you'll be so successful, all right, your fatherhood. Amen. Come on, fathers, hallelujah. All right, your father, your grandfather, it doesn't matter. Just come, all right, Mrs. Nick, hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Come on, let me bless you. All right, you're a victory church, right? I want to see that you walk in, you know, so victorious. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Wonderful Jesus. Wonderful Savior. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Mothers, please put up your hand towards your husband. All right? This is the man. All right? This is the man. This is the priest that God have ordained. Yeah, the priesthood unto the Lord. Alright? Your job is to pray and to intercede for the family. Alright? And they have the strong relationship with the Father in heaven. That they will have the inner man. The river of God will flow upon their life. And wherever they go, they will bring life. Evermore. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Father, I pray, Lord, for your anointing and all your God, your power and authority in the name of Jesus. In the great Father, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, touch his life, oh Father. Open the doors of heaven. Pour out your blessing right now in Jesus' name. Father, I ask for your anointing. And your power and the Spirit of God to come upon his father. Lord, I pray that he will have a strong relationship with the Heavenly Father. In the name of Jesus, Lord, you will walk in the power and authority of the sonship of God. Lord, touch him, O Father. He'll be a great Father. Let the river of God flow from his mouth. Right now, in Jesus' name, let the river flow, Lord. Let the river flow, hallelujah. Father God, I just pray, Lord, for Pastor Joel. I pray for the anointing. I pray, Lord, open the doors of heaven. Pour out the river, Lord, upon his life. I pray as he lead this church, the river will lead him, O God, to victory, O Lord. I pray for his favor of God upon his life, favor of God upon his wife and children, and the favor of God upon his ministry, O God. Lord, that he be made souls this year for the Lord Jesus. Father, open up, Lord, open up the doors of heaven. Pour out your blessing, O God. Protect, O God, your servant, O God, in Jesus' name. Father, I ask for your anointing. Father, anoint. Lord, I pray the anointing of the Spirit of the Lord will give you power and authority, Lord, to live a victorious life. Father, let the river of God flow. Let the river of God flow right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Father, I pray for your anointing. Lord, touch your God, Pastor Diane. In the name of Jesus. Let the river of God, Lord, forever increase, Lord. Touch God's life. I speak health and strength.
Downstairs, there's a lounge area.